here's a demo recording for How to Play Wicked Game by Chris Isaak. We're going to start off with the intro guitar solo that I just played. To start off with, it really helps if you've got one of these things stuck out of your guitar. This is a vibrato arm, sometimes called a tremolo arm, although it shouldn't really be called that because tremolo means to pick really fast. So a vibrato arm or wiggle stick if you're feeling fruity. And to play this, you need to grab that arm in your hand so that you can still pick your strings. Now I will show you a way to play this little bend that he does at the start, even if you've not got one of these, but to start off with, I'll show you how to do it like he does. So you hold that arm in your hand like that, get your pick on your B string and pick your B string open. Now as soon as you do that, you need to gently push the arm down so you make the note go slightly lower like that. Now keep your grip on it and then press down your 7th fret on your B string. Oops. And then release the arm like that. So you pick, push it, pick 7, and release it like that. That's how you get the effect. After that, you can let go of the bar or keep it in your hand because you're going to use it again. Just be careful if you keep it in your hand, try not to move it, otherwise your notes are going to go all over the place. I just drop it down like that. After that, pick 7 again and slide your hand towards the end of the fretboard there to the lower frets. When you start to get down towards the bottom, take your finger off and pick your B string again. That's a slide. After that, we're going to play the first two notes again. And then we play this bit. Now to do that, you need to be playing your 9th fret on your G string. I use my 3rd finger to do that. And we do something called a rake, which is that effect there. What you need to do here is, you can use a combination of your 1st and your 2nd finger and lay them across the 2 strings that are above the G string, the one you're pressing down. Now the effect that you get there is, when you pick those 2 strings, your A and your D, they shouldn't ring like that, or like that. Don't press your finger down, just make sure it's touching the strings. And then you get a muted sound like that. Now, when you go and pick these strings, you need to drag your pick down the strings like this. Imagine it's how you're dragging a stick along some railings, you know, when you were a kid, or maybe you still are. Like that, your pick drags across the string, and as it lands on the next string, you're ready to pick that string again. Now, if you practice the timing, get that cool sort of sound. Alright, so we do that, and then we're going to drop down to 7, and then down to 6, like that. And if you've not noticed yet, I'm picking, I'm trying to pick a little bit more gently here. And then finish off, back on your 9th fret, but on your D string, this time. So that phrase goes. Finish it off, 7 again, still on your D string, then 6. So it's 9, 7, 6, 9, 7, 6. First on G, and then D. And then we're going to repeat it again. Now, after that, we're going to play some arpeggios. Now, your arpeggios sound like this. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. To do this, you've got to hold a little B minor chord. So put your 1st finger on your 2nd fret E string, your 2nd finger on your 3rd fret B, your 3rd finger on your 4th fret G. So each finger is on an adjacent fret. 2, 3, 4, like that. Now, your third finger is not going to come off the strings until right at the end. So leave that third finger there. As we go through, we're going to gradually take one finger off at a time. So to begin with, pick those three strings, and I want you to use your pick and pick up, down, like that. Right. From that point, take your first finger off and just pick the first two strings. So far we've got this. And look at my right hand, if you can see it, hopefully. Right, now after that, get your first finger, put it on the B string now, on the second fret, and tick your second finger off. So you're holding down 4 and 2 now. You're not pressing down your E string anymore. Then pick the B. Oops, pick the B and then G string, like that. So we've got, so far, from the beginning. Right, next part. Take your first and your second finger off, so you've just got your third finger on now, and play the B and G string. Again, like that. There we go. Watch my left hander, probably, yeah. There you go. It's quite a complicated sequence of notes, and you need to be making sure that as you play this, you've got your fingers right on their fingertips, like that. Don't lean your fingers over like this. Otherwise, you're going to touch the strings that are ringing. And on the tab, you'll see it says, let ring throughout this part. That means that you need to let the notes overlap, and you do that by holding your fingers on the fingertips. If you're struggling to reach that, keep your thumb down on the back about halfway like that. If your thumb wraps around, your fingers tend to lean over on the sideways like that. So after you've done that little part there, you're going to go onto your second fret G and slide your first finger down to your first fret, but you're going to pick both notes. This is a shift slide. From that point, pick one again, and go back to two. So it goes 2, 1, 1, 2. And then after that, pick two again, and quickly slide up to 4. Now, on that one, you don't pick the second note. See? My hand's up here. That's called a slow slide, because it's smooth, like that. Right, so those are all the parts of the introduction. That comes back later on in the song as well, in the guitar solo. Now, for the rest of the song, you can do a really simple strumming part to play along to this. We're going to use three chords, B minor, which is 2, 4, 4, 3, and then 2 again with your first finger barring on the E string, A major, and E major. I'm going to show you those chords because you should probably know those if you're learning this song already, and if you're one of my guitar students, you definitely will. And your strumming pattern sounds like this. So we're playing slower. Here we go. 3, 4. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. Like with any strumming pattern, if you're finding it hard to play that and change chords, if this sort of thing's happening, if it's not feeling fluent, just pick one chord that you can play easily. E is a nice example for this because you can play all 6 strings. And just sit. Two chords, maybe A and E, not the first one, and just try switching. Keep strumming, no matter what happens, keep strumming. Right, Once you can play that strumming pattern, you can play that pretty much through the whole song. Listen to the song. At some points, the little arpeggios come back now and again, so you can play those parts. But that's all you need to be able to play the song. Okay, if you enjoyed this video, I'm just trying to get down to see you here. Let me know in the comments if there's another video you'd like to do. Just send me a message and I'll see if I can put it up there at some point. If there's anything you found useful in this video as well, please try and let me know. Thanks for watching.